listens to the Smooch Bar, reflecting on what's been a pretty average night, in all honesty, but a terrible, terrible night overall. Wales have gone out of their Euro qualifier. Home game against Poland. Against Poland, drawing 0-0 after extra time, going down 5-4 on penalties. Dan James was the one that missed the penalty. England drew 2-2 with Belgium, a last gasp equaliser from Jude Bellingham. But I'm afraid the story from Wales is glorious failure. Still getting out of that Gareth Bale shadow is found itself a little bit too hard. They got themselves there on the back of those Gareth Bale goals, in all honesty. But this young squad couldn't quite get over the line. TalkSport Dean Saunders, former Wales and Liverpool striker, is joining us now from Cardiff. Dino?
Yeah, I can hear you putting that laughing,
Dino, noise,
on.
Dino,
I mean,
it was bang, it's bang out of order. Dino, I said, listen, Dino,
if you give it out, you've got to take it.
We've got to go in here with a little bit of empathy here.
He's not interested.
Look. This is just, it's bang out of order.
Jason, fair play. If you give it out, you've got to take it. Yeah, so I give it out, I got to take it.
No, Dino, you're good at both. I mean, fair play. But, look, listen, I know it's raw, and I know what it's like, because I've been on the receiving end of it, and I've given it out as well. But right now is probably not the right time. We've got plenty of time for that.
We've got plenty of time.
Weeks and months before the Euro starts.
It's a disgrace.
It's terrible stuff for me. But no, Dino, you made the point there. He made one change. He put Johnson alongside Wilson. He took off Brooks. You said there that Brooks had an injury and he started more up top. The thing that struck me about the game, and I've got to say, I was watching mostly England, but the one thing that struck me is how toothless both sides looked. Both sides really, you can make an argument, didn't deserve to get to Germany in the summer.
Well, I thought Poland, we've played football, right? And we've all been in the dressing room when the manager comes in and said, this lot are there for the taking. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They're waiting to get beat. I think if we'd have scored first, Poland would have caved in. They were looking like they're in an ageing group. They don't come back when they go a goal down. History tells you that. Lewandowski didn't look the same player that I've been watching. And yeah. I mean, today he didn't really have a chance. So took his penalty well. But the questions are going to be thrown at Robert Page. Should you have started with Kiefer Moore? Or should you have kept the same team? Why did he change it? Why didn't you bring Aaron Ramsey on? Why didn't you bring Ramsey on to take a penalty? Why did Nathan Broadhead come on and not take a penalty? So these questions, when you lose, they're going to be chucked at you as a manager, and he's going to have to face that in a minute. But I could actually be physically sick right now. I feel that bad.
Jay, Dino, so when you look at it, it's hindsight. It's always better hindsight. What would you have done when you look at it from your angle right now? What would you have done differently?
From the start, I mean, I thought we played all right, but it's team selection, right? He's got a choice. You either have a little of the ball and you then it Brennan Johnson when there's a bit of grass behind their back four, and you break with the runners we've got, Harry Wilson. Or if you think you're going to have a load of the ball and you're going to push them back, then the ball eventually has to go into the box. You play Kiefer Moore, who keeps the ball in the box, and he gets on the end of crosses. So there's two options, and we had that option when Chris Coleman was manager with Robson Kanu, who's the runner, and Sam Vokes was the big striker that he'd bring on. They'd change them both for different games. But I thought after winning the way we did against Finland, he would have kept the same team. But I'm not sure whether David Brooks was feeling something, and that's why he didn't start him. So you'd have to ask the manager that.
Dino, listen, you've had both legs at home, right? So you've had the advantage of having both of those games at home. And against Finland, I watched that game. You ran out quite comfortable winners in the end. The 4-1, it might have flattered you a little bit, but actually you were the better side. Tonight, having that home leg, you never made advantage of that. You never took advantage. You never really took the game by the scruff of the neck, from what I could see. You never made that home advantage count. And that must be disappointing, because I can hear the crowd behind you now. Even when the last penalty was missed.
That's Poland, Jace.
Oh, wow.
Are they still here?
Is it?
I know what you're saying, right? Dear. Well, what's happened? We were taking the game to teams when Gareth Bale retired. I think we thought we were better than we are. And we've gone at our teams like Armenia and got counter-attacked. And they scored 4 goals past us. So what he's done, before he got sacked, because he was on the brink of getting sacked, he's changed the shape. And we've gone to a back five. he's put Ethan Ampadu and Jordan James as destroyers in front of the back four, and then we counter-attack.
Yep.
And we've let four goals in 7 games. Another clean sheet tonight, so it's worked. You know, we've gone that many games, we've only let 4 goals in. So, tonight, I spoke about it, Jason. You get nights like this, and Carlton, you would have had nights, and Jace, you've got to win.
Somehow,
you've got to get over the line.
It doesn't matter how good or bad you play, just win.
Yeah.
Well, listen, I mean, the Gareth Southgate syndrome, if you like. I mean, tonight, I don't think we're going to play bad. We're going to take calls now. I actually thought we deserved to win the game. I thought we were decent. Individual errors cost us. When we come off that pitch 2-1 down, the call, I know the rhetoric's going to be, it's going to be exactly the same that happened at the weekend. The truth is, Rob Page had everything in his hand, and it's about playing the right cards, going to extra time at home, and going out on penalties. It's a terrible result for Wales. It's a terrible result.
No, it is.
You know, I just want to know, you mentioned Rob Page on the verge of the sack, and I remember that. I know it's a young squad, and it's finding a way to get out of that Gareth Bale shadow, right?
Yeah.
I understand. But tonight, that puts him back, sets him Wales back. I just wonder, will there be question marks about his job, or do you think he's done enough to this point? I know things weren't great. To justify next campaign?
Yeah, I think we're on the right road. You know, like the way the shape of the team he's got now, we're counter attacking, right? And sat in that dressing room tonight, you've got cup finals, you've got England against Italy in the last big game that England never got over the line. When you sat in that dressing room, if you're Harry Wilson, David Brooks, Brennan Johnson, Kiefer Moore, I've got to score a goal tonight.
Yeah,
that is my job. In a big game where it counts, not against Armenia at home, we got a crunch game tonight, and I have got to produce the goods in my position. I can't make a mistake at the back, not in a big game like this. No. Ben Davis was outstanding, by the way, and Roden had a great game. The three of them kept Lewandowski quiet. But the other end of the pitch, when you look tonight, when they go home, Harry Wilson, Brennan Johnson, David Brooks, or Kiefer Moore, I haven't scored.
And that's their job. They needed to.
Yeah.
Especially in a game of this magnitude.
Yeah, and they were there for the taking, by the way.
At home.
Yeah. Dina, we're going to get the line. Stay with us. Andrew is in. He's a Cardiff fan. Andrew, good evening. Welcome to the show, my friend.
You okay, boys?
Not too bad,
have you been at the game?
Yeah, heartbroken. Get it.
Okay.
This is too early for that. Come
Andrew,
on, this,
you've rung the wrong show, mate. These two are taking the mickey.
Dino, don't put me in. I'm not.
They don't care about us.
Oh no, I do. I've got empathy.
Let Andrew speak.
I can't understand what Page has done tonight. To be honest, sir. You just summed it up for me. They got to be sad in that change room tonight. Johnson, Kiefer Moore, Dan James, everybody, and they just got to be thinking, how are we not scored tonight? Defensively, this campaign, we've been excellent. All right, we had a slip-up against Armenia and whatever. But defensively, we've been tracking. How did we not go out there tonight and win that game?
What's your view on Aaron Ramsey not playing, the most experienced player in that squad?
Rambo's been carrying an injury for a long time, haven't he? You know, I'm a Cardiff fan. I watch him.
But in a one-off game like this, If you know what I'm saying, in a one-off game like this, don't you want that man in the middle of the park?
But is he fit enough to be on there?
Well, he played 18 minutes against Swansea at the weekend.
Yeah.
And he didn't look right. But
no,
he's probably thinking, I've got Ampadu playing, Jordan James playing every week. I mean, I maybe have brought him on to take a penalty.
I brought him on right late in the game.
In injury time,
That's what I thought. Yeah.
Extra time, sorry.
You'd have brought him on.
Andrew, listen, commiserations, safe journey home. Keep them coming, gang. 0371722344. Dino, thank you very much, mate. What are you up to now?
I'm going to book my room at Porthcawl Beach for June.
Right.
I'm going to stay in Wales, I think.
Yeah.
Dino, it was in the palm of your hand. I mean, you blame Dan James. I mean, don't blame James. We know what it's like.
To be honest, their summer's already over, man. They've not got nothing to look forward
to. Dino, your summer's not over, mate.
It is over. It's done.
My summer's finished now.
Are you supporting England, gate?
Of course he is. His dad's English.
Dino.
His dad's English.
Yeah. You're supporting England this summer?
Yeah, of course he is.
No. No.
What do you mean?
Not now, because of the way you've treated me in the last 20 minutes.
No, that was not me. That was Cundy.
Dino, I wanted you to get Dino, there purely selfish reasons.
I've got pure respect for you.
No, for pure selfish reasons, for Talk Sport and the sports bar, I wanted you guys to get there so we could humiliate you when you were out there. I didn't realise you were going to let us in early, Dino.
Of all the things you've said tonight, I think you might be right when you said glorious failure.
Glorious failure, mate.
We had it in our hands tonight. We're at home against Poland, who were dead on their feet.
Dino, how are you feeling right now?
I feel gutted, but I've been there myself. You know, we're Wales. I've been there, so I'm not going to criticise him.
Dino, get your cell phone, bud. I'll send you a message.
Don't try and get around me now, Jay. I'm sending you a message. I'm not answering it.
Yeah, don't.
No.
Dino, unlucky, mate. Commiserations, glorious failure. There is Dean Saunders, former Liverpool and Welsh striker, reflecting what was a disappointing night in Cardiff. 0-0 over the 90 minutes plus extra time. Went to pens, 5-4.
The Sports Bar with Jamie O'Hara and Jason Cundy. Monday to Thursday nights from 10 on AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.